Hi, I'm Mike Naughton, chair of the physics department at Boston College, and also a Buffalo Bills fan all my life. Therefore, I don't have a dog in this fight, but I do believe the science should be done right. And so I'm here to talk about just the science of what could happen when you take balls from a warm environment, put them in a cold environment. So for better or worse, this has been a large part of the national dialogue for this past week. And a lot of misinformation, or basically uninformed information, is out there, including theories about what could or did happen. Myself, I don't believe any theory. I believe experiment. So presently, we're doing an experiment with a Wilson NFL football where we pressurize the football at 13.5 PSI, and we want to see if it obeys the ideal gas law. Does the pressure follow the temperature? So we know the starting temperature and pressure. We place it in a controlled environment in a refrigerator at a controlled temperature. We're going to let it equilibrate, measure the pressure, and see what we get. So after conducting our experiment, we pressurized at 13.5 PSI at 72 degrees Fahrenheit. Then we cooled the ball to 42 degrees Fahrenheit, 30 degrees lower than the starting pressure. We find in the end 10.5 PSI for the pressure of that ball, a full 3 PSI drop. That's even larger drop than one would predict by the ideal gas law, which perhaps could be explained by the effect of humidity, which was not accounted for, and there certainly was humidity in that air. And so it's unambiguous we can get large pressure drops by lowering the temperature, as we should. So what's the upshot of this experiment? We got a 3 PSI drop with a 30 degree drop in temperature, which is at least consistent with anything I've heard from the New England Patriots side. So what can we expect on Sunday at the Super Bowl? One thing to consider is if any ball is pressurized at the upper end of the NFL range in an air-conditioned locker room, it's going to be brought outside in the Arizona heat, and it's going to go above that range. So you can see physics works both ways.